Hello friends, this is Durga from IIT University. This video is part of a course called as CCA Data Analyst in which HiveScoop and Impala are covered quite extensively. If you want to learn any of these technologies or prepare for the certification, you can enroll for our course for $10 by going through the information in description. Also, we provide something called as Big Data Developer Labs. If you want to sign up for the labs and practice, you can actually go to the description and click on the link to get details about the labs. If you are not subscribed to our channel yet, please do so by clicking on the subscribe button and also click on notify button so that you get notified whenever we create free content as part of our channel. When we perform scoop import on a table where there is a primary key, that primary key will be used to divide the data into mutually exclusive subsets, and then there will be multiple threads to pull the data from the source database and dump into the HDFS location. However, there can be a scenario where there are no primary keys or unique keys defined. In that case, either you have to use one mapper or you have to specify the field on which data has to be distributed using split by column. The best practice when we specify split by is to mention the column name which is indexed and also does not have null values in the database. If it have null values, then those rows might be skipped, and also if it is not indexed, the performance can be poor. So let us first review the database, and then we'll try to import a table where there is no primary key on top of the table. So here I'm using scoop eval or scoop list tables connecting to the database using JDBC. So JDBC colon MySQL colon /ms.itversity.com 3306 retail underscore db, and then username which is nothing but retail underscore user, and then password which is nothing but itversity. You can see the list of tables here. One of the table is nothing but order underscore items underscore no pk. The table does not have any primary key or unique key defined on top of it, and hence if we have to import that, either we have to specify number of mappers as 1 or we have to specify the split by field. But if there is no index on that field, it will perform full table scan in each and every thread, and because of that, the performance can be very poor. So here is the table, order items underscore no pk. You can run scoop eval command like this, and then copy paste the connector string and username, and then you can specify password itversity. Then you should be able to run the query using hyphen hyphen query describe order items no pk. Now if you hit enter, it will actually show the metadata of this table, the column names, data types, etc. Earlier when we actually reviewed some of the tables where there are primary keys on top of it, we have seen a field called as keys, and there is PRI in it. Now with this table, as there is no primary key defined on it, there won't be any key. You can see here, key, nothing is here, which means there is no primary key on this table. However, there is no index also on this table, and hence if we specify a non-indexed field as part of the split by clause, each and every thread will actually copy the data using full table scan. It will apply the full table scan on the underlying table, get everything, and then apply the filter criteria to pull the mutually exclusive subset of data in each thread, and then it will load into the target. It can actually create serious performance issues on the source databases, and hence you have to be extremely careful when you try to increase the parallel degree of more than one on those tables where there are no primary keys or indexes defined. We'll get into those details as we proceed further. First, let us see how we can import this table using one thread. So here I can say scoop import, and then the connector string, username and password. So I can copy paste these three things. Table is nothing but order items no pk. Warehouse directory is nothing but user training scoop import retail underscore db. I'm mentioning delete target directory here. If I run this command, it will fail, saying that either you have to specify split by clause or you have to use number of mappers as 1. You can see here, either you have to specify number of mappers as 1 like this, or you have to specify split by. Let's say we want to use split by and leave the default parallel degree, which is nothing but 4. In that case, we just have to say scoop import and then copy paste this command from here to here. Then we can say split by. In this case, I am specifying the field which is not indexed. As our data set is not very big, we are good to go. But if your data set size is pretty big, then you will run into serious performance issues, not only on the scoop job, but also on the source database. And hence, you have to be extremely careful while importing a very large table where there is no index defined on it using higher parallel degree than 1. So if I say split by like this, and then specify the field, let's say order item ID, then specify delete target directory. This time it will use this order item ID as bounding wells query field, and then it will compute the split size. Using that split size, it should be able to import the data without any challenges. However, from the performance perspective, as this field is not indexed field, it can be very slow if the data size is very big. You can see that data is successfully imported. It have used order item ID, which is specified as part of the split by in this bounding vals query. Using that, it actually computed the split size, and using this split size, it actually imported the data from source table into the HDFS. Alternative way to import this table where there is no primary key is by specifying nummappers as 1. So here I can copy the command from here to here, then say scoop import, paste it, and then nummappers 1 or hyphen m1, and then delete target directory. Now if I hit enter, it will be able to import the data with only one thread, and hence we'll be seeing only one file in this location with order items underscore nopk as subdirectory, as we have specified warehouse directory here. You can see that number of splits is 1 and there is no bounding vals query, so it will actually skip that step of getting the min and max value, as there is no a split by field or primary key on this table. Even if there is primary key, if we specify hyphen m1 or hyphen hyphen nummappers as 1, it will skip the bounding vals query. However, it have imported all the rows here. You can also run Hadoop fs-ls on this warehouse directory with order underscore items underscore nopk as subdirectory, and you will be seeing only one file here. It has to be order underscore items underscore nopk. Now we will be seeing only one file here because the number of mappers is 1. So the import job, which uses only one thread, if the table is very big, might be slow, but it will not impact the source database. But if you specify split by and if you jack up the number of mappers to a very high value, and as part of the split by, if the field is not indexed, then it will actually perform full table scan in each and every thread, and it can cause serious issues on the source database. So you have to be extremely careful while loading a very large table using split by field, especially if that split by field is not indexed. If you use number of mappers as 1, in some databases you might run into some database related issues, but it will not impact any source application. For example, if you use Oracle, you might run into snapshot 2 old error because of the undo being outdated if the scoop import takes very long if you use only one thread. So there are pros and cons between split by and nummappers 1 when you want to import the data from a table where there is no index or primary key field using split by versus number of mappers as 1. You really need to understand the problem and come up with the solution which is apt for your situation.